All mothers are women, and all mothers are of divine grace. They bestow us with a gift called life, one to cherish and embrace. From the womb until we are old, mothers are the epitome of unconditional love. But deep down in their hearts, perhaps they too have a tragedy to let go of. Hence, on this Mother's Day, I present the tale of my beloved mom, woven into a piece of poetry with warmth and care alone. My mother is a lady, million to one in a sea, who is blessed with virtues of courage, power, and tolerance for her destiny. Fate, as we name it, is somewhat thorny like a desert cactus. She has been pricked by its wicked barb even more than once. Oh dear mother, why do you suffer silently? I ask in tears. Mom replies in wonder. A strong woman can endure much without fears. My mother is a woman, owning respect for herself. Not her vanity, but a matter of dignity in excel. It was on the first day she went to a preschool, with high hopes of friendship and to abide by the rules. Rather, she encountered humiliation from a pal with reasons unknown. Or was it just for mirth? As a result, she cast it aside and enrolled in a better academy which valued her worth. Mom was in her childhood days, pleasant and delightful in the vicinity. Melody in her voice is that of a sweet robin, which fetched her much affinity. She was focused on singing out her best vocals in a show once. A few tough locals were caught in a dispute amongst an impulse. Mom's ongoing concert was disturbed by the unrest of hue and cries. Never had she agreed for a song there, even after several begs and tries. My mother is a devotee who worships in gaining knowledge. She is an educated soul with high thoughts cultivated over the age. My mother greatly regarded matters of family ties in her maiden year. Her father was a constant support as friend and guide of joys and woes to hear. Ma, as she called her mother, was the person of solace, fed her sweets with feelings and care. My mother had two siblings, older than her, bosomed in the early days, which later blazed into flare. Relation with her sisters had taken a backseat long before. When my mom's hard-earned money got robbed for, my mother confronted her eldest sister, who didn't care to request or appeal. Grandmother came to mom's aid, while the sister turned hostile to reveal. The two elder sisters cracked evil plans against mother, poisoned minds of mom's dears, one after another. As time flied by, my mother found a friend in father. After marriage, they settled in a life of happily ever after. My mother was blessed and prized amongst in-laws. With respect and regard, she had won the hearts with applause. Such dedicated and dutiful is the woman I adore of sense. My mother, whom I honor as the queen of excellence. But the kinfolk of my mother made issues of things petty and small. Was it just a mistake or jealousy to recall? Mother was desperate and made efforts to mend their ways. Alas, my poor mother suffered their mental blows for days. Her parents were kept hushed, not to say a word for her. My father consoled mother, and together they withstood further. Several times, mom had come across acquaintances who stressed her out. At times, they carved lies at my school of false charges about. These lies took a toll on my health, and I was identified with epilepsy, where I often collapsed, and mother came to my rescue like a brave heart quickly. Such resilient and revered is the woman I admire of this essence. My mother, whom I acclaim as the queen of lenience. Things took a turn for the worse when my grandfather was counting his days. Mom rushed to her father as often as she could to stay beside him always. Mother sang tunes to grandfather, who instilled music in her. But the sisters, in hatred, forbade mother and rebuked of such dare. What was wrong in singing to her ailing father? Or was my innocent mother a woman to disdain in every sphere? The day came when grandfather left for his heavenly abode. Mom was shattered because her father, her guide and mentor, was no more. "Do come and see your father once, duty calls," the relatives gave order to mom. "Father will be in my heart, a life and in joy," said mother in calm. Perhaps for the first time ever, a daughter didn't visit the house of death. For she couldn't bear to see the sight of her father lost in sleep without a breath. The kith and kin of mother didn't leave a chance to torment even my father. But mother was strong enough not to live by the society in fear. Of what use were such norms and rituals when the old man was no more? When my mother was refrained from serving her father, wasn't that a sin to deplore? I salute my mom who followed her heart. She worships her father since then through music and art. Mom visited her mother to ease the pain and grief, to console one another of grandfather's demise, to believe. But grandmother was helpless. She was restricted in bed and docile to her eldest daughter, who prohibited my mom's entry in the house and confronted her soon after. One fine morning came the news of grandmother being no more. Mom was crestfallen. She had no clue of how to calm downfall. My mother had visited her ancestral house some days back then. Grandmother had blessed us in abundance once and again. However, my mother had to seek consent in terror, had to step into the house when her siblings weren't there. My mom thus broke the rule, abstained from seeing her lifeless mother, because she had promised to keep her parents alive in her memory forever. My mother is both a rebel and reformer, to say. She is staunch in decisions, even if she has to pay. Never for once has she forgiven her devious Keith or all those who had seized her right to serve her parents from close. Such strong and striking is the woman I salute of this deference, my mother, whom I commend as the queen of endurance. My mother is a woman, kind and gentle. If one seeks her aid, she would rescue them to settle. People love her for the helping hand she lends at times of distress. To make this world a better place is mom's dream to redress, where mutual respect and compassion would prevail. No person would ever be deprived of amity in entail. My mother soon rose to heights in many of her ventures. A society inspired by mom was formed with a new beginning for talent in need of nurtures. Mom guided all to impart lessons of right and wrong. Was it a mistake of my mother to ascertain norms to get along? Too bad the squad who stood against mother couldn't keep up the newly found alliance for long. But my poor mother felt sorry for them. If only they realized mom and where her morals belong. People who are met by luck treasure mother's words for sure. Thoughts of wisdom preached by mom of being a teacher so pure. I have seen my mother making every effort to make all smile. Has anyone ever read her mind that bleeds of anguish all the while? I have seen her being blamed for matters beyond her control. Yet she has shown unflinching courage in her robust soul. I am seasoned of bearing such desolation and dejection, mother sighs. Those for whom she had incurred all efforts shot harsh words in rise. How could she bear such vile and insult from a team? People odious, mean of mind in days, wrecked mother's awaited dream. Mother now lives in alarm. How could the world speak ill of the woman who does good to one and all? Notwithstanding such irrelevant wounds, she still emerges vigorous and stands tall. My mother is a woman, unbeatable, unstoppable. She keeps aside her sorrows, never to lament or fail. Shorbori, as we know her, is the symbol of valor, be it in the day or night. In the darkness too, she reigns bravely with might. Oh dear mother, I bow down before you, but do not you mourn in silence. You are beyond comparison, O Queen of Reverence.